Hi viewers, this is Kumar. You are watching Kumar's Academy. Today I am going to teach you about 18th century or Augustan age, especially the poetry. So we know that there are many great writers who has contributed a lot for the 18th century literature, and one among them is Alexander Pope, who was born in 1688 and died in 1744, and second one Matthew Friar, who was born in 1664 and died in 1721. I'm going to tell you about the Alexander Pope, but because already I have made a special video on Alexander Pope and his works and his life and everything, so it is, I am suggesting you that please watch that and understand who is Alexander Pope. And next I am going to tell you about Matthew Friar. Matthew Friar is also one of the leading poet of 18th century or Augustan age. Matthew Friar, who was born in 1664 and died in 1721. He was a Tory. He was a supporter of Tory. And whatever the poetry he wrote in England, especially before 18th century, when Charles II was the king, so he formed the two parties. One is Tories, another one is Whig. And domestically, the people divided among the two parties. So like that, Matthew Prior, who was a arch supporter of a Tory, and his, for that reason, the power of the Tories, he received many higher positions and valuable appointments in the government of Tories. His important works we can know now. He has written very best and very prominent work, that it is The Story of the Country Mouse and The City Mouse, which was written in 1687, and it was written with the collaboration with Charles Montagu, and it is a parody on Dryden's Hind and Panther. He wanted to just imitate the style of Dryden. Even Matthew Prior has written many other poems. The most important poems, they are Alma, or The Progress of the Mind, which was written in 1718. And in this poem, he imitated Samuel Butler's Hoodie Brass. And the third one, Solomon, The Vanity of the World, which was written on the same year of 1718. And it was written in a heroic couplet. And other short pieces that he has written, and they are Chameleon, Thief and the Cordelier, and the third one, the poem is Glow. I'm going to introduce one more poet, John Gay. John Gay, who was born in 1685 and died in 1732. He was born in very humble circumstances, very humble family. Later, he apprenticed as a skill mercer and died in London as an idler, because of his extravagance life and of his no interest in particular things. So he has written very important poems, and including the plays. The first one, it is Rural Sports, which was written in 1713 in heroic couplet. The Shepherd's Wig, it is his second poem. And third one, What Did He Call? It was written in 1715. It is a pastoral farce. The another one, the fourth one, is he's a very famous poem, The Trivia, or The Art of Walking the Street of London, which was written in 1716. It is a parody of a heroic style. The name was taken from the goddess of crossroads, Dinah Trivia. And the last one, sixth one, The Beggar's Opera, which was written in 1728. It is his masterpiece, and it was his last play also. It was performed 62 times at that time in London and many other places. It has a boisterous humor, and it marked the beginning of the tradition of the comic opera. So next, now we can see another writer, Edward Young. Edward Young, who was born in 1683 and died in 1762. And his major works are The Last Day, 1714. The second one, The Force of Religion, which was written in 1714. Third one, The Lover of Fame, which was written between 1725 to 28. And in this poem, he used the heroic couplet, especially the advanced kind of heroic couplet. And fourth one, The Complaint or The Night Thought. It is a masterpiece, and it may be called like The Complaint or The Night Thoughts on a Life, Death and Immorality, which was written in 1742. And in this poem, he has written it in a blank verse. Next poet is Sir Samuel Garth, who was born in 1661 and died in 1719. He is called the older man of other poets. He is a very popular physician, and he is the person who assisted Pope in the first effort of pastorals when he was writing. And his best work is called The Dispensary, which was written in 1699. Next poet, the woman poet, she is Lady Winchilsea. She was born in 1661 and died in 1720. Her important works are the first one, The Spleen, second one, The Pindaric Ode or The Prodigy, which was written in 1706, and third one, Miscellany Poems, which were published in 1713. And this miscellany, which has contained the great poem Nocturnal Reverie, which is a best poem, and it was praised by William Wordsworth. Ambrose Phillips, who was born in 1675 and died in 1749. Satires of Pope on Ambrose Phillips, especially on Eulogy, which led them to quarrel, and Pope who immortalized Phillips in his poems called Dunciad and other poems. His poetry are called namby-pamby because his Christian name, they are called. His best work is The Distressed Mother, which was written in 1712, and it is a tragedy. Next one is Thomas Parnell. Thomas Parnell, who was born in 1679 and died in 1718. He was born in Ireland, and he had really genuine regard for nature. And he wrote very important poem called The Hermit, which was published in 1710, and it was written in heroic couplet. So now I am going to teach you about the last poet, Allan Ramsay. Allan Ramsay, who was born in 1686 and died in 1758. He was a wig maker and unofficially the poet laureate of local. The people were calling him the poet laureate. And he is a literary ancestor of Robert Burns. And he had really genuine regard for the nature, especially the Scotland. He influenced many poets, really the poetry of Ayrshire man. His important works are Lucho Barnomore, The Gentle Shepherd, which was written in 1725. So viewers, if you like my video,